वीडियो चेक,
यस 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 द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल या नाउ इट इज फुल स्क्रीन कैन
फुल
चेंज
स्क्रीन,
यस यस
आई ऋषि टंडन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ टाटा मोटर्स वेलकम यू ऑल एंड वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू द ऑफिशियल्स ऑफ ईएमसी केरला बी एंड अदर डिग्नेटरीज ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट एंड माई कलीग्स एंड फेलो फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री. लेट मी टेक दिस ऑस्पिशियस डे ऑफ वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे एंड थैंक यू ऑल फॉर टेकिंग दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कम टूगेदर एंड पार्टिसिपेट इन गो इलेक्ट्रिक कैंपेन organized by EMC. As you all know that Kerala is a very environment conscious and a having a biodiversity and a favorite tourist destination. Kerala government is building up an ecosystem to support e-mobility. So let's begin with this. Goodbye to fuel and hello electric. Next slide please. So there may be a question asked by the people, why to shift in EVs? There are four or five main points which we need to answer ourselves on. Out of 30 most polluted cities in the world, 22 are in India. And then 30% of the pollution in urban areas are contributed by the vehicle. And nonetheless, it is estimated that in the next 10 years time, our import of crude oil will be double. My dear friends, if we go for electric and adopt electric e-mobility, then we can substantially reduce the oil imports and thus saving our precious foreign exchange. And then we can also enhance our energy security. My dear friends, also we can reduce the vehicular population, the pollution within the urban cities. We need to preserve our ecosystem for the future generations. And that's a beginning. And we are very happy to associate with the Kerala and thankful to all of you. Now, there are certain anti-barriers why people are not shifting to e-mobility. Let me take out one by one. Earlier, there were lack of choices of the vehicles available in the market. Then, charging infra, it's like a chicken and egg story, whether the charging infra will come first or the vehicle will be launched with a higher range. Then there was a range anxiety within the people, whether my vehicle will give how many kilometers of range. Then, obviously, we will be, as a purchaser, we'll be comparing with the ICE engine that is a petrol diesel versus electric cars. Please hold on. We have Tata Motors. We have a solution for all the things which I have mentioned. As a Tata group, we are talking about the Tata universe. If you have a problem or thinking about the charging infra, our group company Tata Power is there. We are already installing a lot of number of chargers across the states. Then if you have worry about insurance, then we have a Tata AIG insurance. Then the batteries and the other components are being supplied by our group company, Tata Capital and Auto Components. Then financing is a worry, then it's a no worry because we have Tata Finance and Tata Capital. We are experimenting this store-in-store concept with the Croma. And from Tata Motors, we will provide you the Make in India electric vehicles and buses. Next slide, please. Thanks. First of all, let me thank all of you to win this world's largest or the largest EV tender awarded by the ESL. And let me take you to the journey, how we have progressed in the last few years. In 2018, we carved out our Tata Motor Electrical Business Mobility Unit. Then last year, we commanded a market share of 71% in Tata Motors passenger car electric vehicles. Then with the feedback of our esteemed customer, we launched extended range of Tata Tigor EV Plus in October 2019. And in January 2020, we launched Nexon EV. Proudly to say that more than 4,500 vehicles we have sold Nexon all over India. And special thanks to the Kerala government for adopting e-mobility. And we have built more than 120 vehicles in the government department. It's a taking a lead to adopt e-mobility. Then we are also proudly to say Nexon EV is deployed under the Safe Kerala project. Next slide, please. Here are some accolades we have received from the industry experts like Autocar. We have received winner of the Green Car Award 2021, then IKOTI Award 2021, and the winner of the year from NDTP Car and Bike. These are a few accolades and many more to come with all your support. Let me take this opportunity to introduce my colleague, Sandeep Senani. Sandeep Senani is taking care of South Zone for electric vehicles, namely Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Pondicherry, AP, Telangana. Over to you, Sandeep. And along with Sandeep, we have another three people. Nitin Phillips, he's taking care of Kerala. And my colleague, Sharad Ranjan, he takes care of the service and the new product development. And my colleague, Fayaz Ali Sheikh, so he takes care of the charging. Over to you, Sandeep. All the best. Thanks, everyone. Thanks for giving the opportunity. Thank you. Sandeep, I think you need to unmute yourself. I think host need to give permission to unmute. Anish sir?
Yes, sir. We are working on it. Please hold on.
We have currently two models, namely Tata Tigor EV and Nexon EV, and they cater the different set of customers. We have vehicle for the fleet, we have vehicle for the personal. So to take you forward, my colleague Sandeep will take over. Thanks, Sandeep. Over to you now.
Thank you so much, Rishi. And first of all, greetings to EMC. This is a wonderful initiative on the day, the World Environment Day. What better day to choose? And Kerala being God's own country, where else in all India would you start for such an initiative of thinking about the environment, going green, going electric? I would say three cheers for EMC for this wonderful initiative that they have taken forward. And I think this lays down the seeds for the growth of electric, go green, not only in Kerala, but this is an initiative for all India. And we from Tata Motors stand by very, very strongly for the kind of wonderful initiative that EMC has put forward, even Kerala government. I mean, in all of India, this is the first state where we have been able to provide electric vehicles for the Safe Kerala project, right? And just to share that Tata Motors is working on Kerala along with the Kerala government and with EMC and the other departments along with ESL to such a great extent that we are getting to see good feedback from not only from the government but also from customers. If I were to share, we have close to about 78% market share in Kerala for the last financial year, and Kerala takes lead not only in terms of cars but also the support in terms of charging stations, in terms of the people's consciousness to go electric. Like most of the people who have already experienced electric cars abroad or outside of India, they have come back and they've realized that we need to take care of our environment. We need to take care of our mother nature, our country, and that's how we are going electric. So like Rishi mentioned, first of all, thank you, Rishi, for such a wonderful presentation. The first car that we have is Tigor Electric. It has a 21.5 kilowatt hour battery, a certified range of 213 kilometers. It does a full charge in 60 to 90 minutes. From a safety point of view, we have dual airbags, automatic transmission, and a speed up to 80 kilometers per hour. You can see that the car, the body, the exterior of the car looks really wonderful, and it looks very contemporary and modern. Next, Nitin. Nitin next. So while Nitin goes to the next slide, we have the Nexon Electric, which is our next car. And this is one of the most successful electric cars till date in India. If you take in terms of volumes, if you take in terms of impressions that we have had, the car looks beautiful. It's a compact SUV, the first one in the country. And if you see, it has a very good, wonderful aspirational design. It's a connected car. It's not just a standalone car. It has 35 connected car features. It has a certified range of 312, a warranty of 8 years, 1.6 lakh kilometers. We have the biggest and the largest network for electric cars, which is very, very essential in today's world. We give a free home charger with every electric car that we deliver. The on-road price of the car is very, very competitive because Tata believes in giving value for not a particular section of the population, but for the masses. And we have flexible ownership options as well. In terms of safety, the car is wonderful. It has dual airbags, ESP, EBD, and ABS. You name it, and we have taken care of that. A good ground clearance, a power of 129 PS, torque of 245 Newton meter torque, and the only car in the segment to have a 0 to 100 kilometer speed in 9.9 seconds. Yes, you heard that right, 9.9 seconds. And a fast charging in 1 hour, you get 80%. So that's how good the car is. And it's a pure electric car, no hybrid, no other means. It has a permanent magnet synchro mesh motor with Ziptron technology. Next, Nitin. As you look at the car, we have dual tool options. We have 16 inch diamond color cut alloy wheels, 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system, leather wrap steering wheel, fully automatic climate control, dual airbags, Z-Connect app, which ensures that you can even switch on the AC of your car sitting from a remote location. We have keyless entry also, just to ensure that this car is built for the future and it's built keeping in mind the environment as well. Next, Nitin. So while Nitin goes to the next slide, let me also share that this car has got so many awards for not just being a good design car, but also from an environment perspective, also from a connected car perspective. This is how the bare driveline of the car looks like. Front, you have the motor. Base, you have the battery of the vehicle. Many people, like I was hearing the speech initially, that people have so many myths about electric car, but this is one of the most strongest and robust products of Tata Motors. Through regenerative braking, we're able to get about 10 to 15% back, just like how the dynamo is used in a cycle where the power goes, the mechanical energy is converted to electrical. Similarly here, every time you move and brake the car, you get more power back into the battery. Next, Nitin. In terms of performance, it is a highly accelerated long range car. It gives a charge of 60 minutes, fast charging within 60 minutes of at least 100 kilometers, 150 kilometers, 8 years warranty. It's a connected car, which is a smart car. And in terms of comfort, it gives you clutch-free driving, noise-free driving, and it's hassle-free and maintenance-free. I mean, it's reduced maintenance, but I wouldn't call it maintenance-free. So those are the benefits that you get in this electric car. Next, Nitin. Next. From here on, like every car has, for example, a fuel station is very important for an ICE car. For electric car, charging is very important. And herein, I have my colleague Nitin Philip, who will brief you through of what Tata has played a role in terms of electric cars. In the meanwhile, I request Anish to please unmute Nitin so that Nitin could probably take on this part of charging from here. And Nitin will share you of how well we have worked across charging, across Kerala, across India, and the charging infrastructure that we provide all along with the car. Nitin, are you able to speak?
Yeah, am I audible, sir?
Yeah, absolutely. Go ahead.
Thank you, Sandeep, sir, for taking us through the amazing features of Nexon EV and Tigor EV. Namaskaram, Elarkan, namaskaram. From here onwards, I'll be taking you through the charging experience that comes up with the Nexon EV. One of the key factors while owning an EV is the charging experience. So we at Tata Motors, we have ensured that all our customers has an seamless and a hassle-free user experience. So along with every car, we give a charging box complimentary, and it also comes up with a free installation. So once the vehicle, once charging unit is installed at your residence or at your preferred address or the location, you can track the charging, the vehicle charging via an app. You can plug it into any of the 50 ampere power plus socket that is available in your household or at the office space. What we have seen in Kerala and most of India is customers drive around for the day. They come back, park their vehicle at the garage and charge it overnight. Now we have a feature of auto cutoff. So which makes it that, you know, the customers, you just have to need to plug in and forget about it. And meanwhile, when you wake up in the morning, the vehicle is 100% charged. When the charge reaches 100%, there is an automatic cutoff. So you don't have to unplug the charging unit as well. Also, you get all the smart prompts in your phone, in the app, as well as in the car as well, wherever there's a low charge or when the vehicle is fully charged. Going forward with RSP at Tata Motors, we provide the three types of solutions when it comes to e-mobility. We provide vehicles to the government, where the government, various government departments can purchase cars from us on a lease basis via the ESL route. We also have a fleet segment of customers where we primarily pitch our vehicles, the sedan segment, for the taxi operators and for the employee transportation. So we are the market leaders in fleet segment as well, where almost 2,000 to 3,000 vehicles are plying on road for the employee transportation. The third category is obviously the people like me and you, where the private and the personal segment. Here we have Nexon EV, where it has got an amazing 8-year powertrain warranty. It has exclusive special financing, green financing options. It also comes up with a subscription model, but this subscription model is currently active in the key metropolitan cities. Talking about the government customers that we have been giving our vehicles. A lot of central government departments have already purchased our Nexon EVs and Tigor EVs. PMO office, Niti Aayog are some of the key departments that have been purchased our vehicles by the leasing method. When we talk about state governments, there's a lot of Maharashtra, Delhi, Madhya Pradesh, all the key departments from each of these states have been using Nexon EVs and Tigor EVs. Particularly in Kerala, we have Anert, we have ESL, we have given vehicle to the Energy Distribution Center and all other departments as well. Talking about the charging infra. Now, the charging infrastructure here, when we talk about Nexon EVs, these are the public charging stations which support the fast charging unit. And we have a lot of stakeholders currently who are developing the fast chargers across India. Currently, there are over 900 charging stations, public charging stations, where the customers can go along the highways, right, where the key touch points, so that you can ensure that you can go for a long drive. The key stakeholders right now are broadly categorized into government agencies like ESL, Indian Oil, NTPC. There are a lot of DISCOMs at various state departments, like KSEB in India, in Kerala, has been in the forefront of installing fast chargers across Kerala. They have a plan of 64 fast chargers in the first phase and another 264 fast chargers to be set up in the second phase. We also have quite a few private players where our sister concern Tata Power is also involved in this. Our plan is to almost all of the 300 touch points that we have in the Tata Motors, where the dealerships and the service touch points, you're planning to install fast chargers there as well. We also have certain startups that are involved in developing the charging infra across India, namely Voltec, ChargeMode, ChargeGrid. So these are the private players where the other stakeholders where we are planning to kind of improve the charging infra across India. With that, we finish off our session. Before we finish off, I would like to just appreciate AMC to come up with this wonderful initiative. We at Tata Motors are committed to go green, and we plan to electrify Kerala completely in the coming years. Thank you, AMC, for allowing us to taking part in the inauguration event of the Go Green Electric campaign. We'll ensure that we'll support in all such initiatives in future, where we are planning to kind of completely overhaul the ICE vehicles and making into electric. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Rishi Tandon sir, Sandeep, and Nitin Philip. So that was a very wonderful session on electric vehicles. So I welcome Johnson sir, the head NM National Mission for Enhanced Energy Efficiency and DSM Division of Energy Management Center to give a note. Thank you. Johnson, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Are you audible?
Audible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay.
Sir.
Yeah. The participants have any questions or queries, you have put in the chat box. We may give clarification your queries. ഇന്ന് ലോക പരിസ്ഥിതി ദിനമാണ്. ഈ ദിവസം എനർജി മാനേജ്മെന്റ് സെന്റർ ഗോ ഇലക്ട്രിക് ക്യാമ്പയിന്റെ ഒരു ഓഫ്ലൈൻ മോഡ് ക്യാമ്പയിനും എക്സിബിഷൻ ആണ് ഇന്ന് പ്ലാൻ ചെയ്തിരുന്നത്. എന്നാൽ കോവിഡിന്റെ പശ്ചാത്തലത്തിൽ ഇന്ന് നമുക്ക് ഒരു ലോഞ്ചിങ് ഓൺ വെബിനെയർ മോഡിലേക്ക് മാറ്റേണ്ടി വന്നു. അപ്പൊ അതില് അതുകൊണ്ട് തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും ഇതുമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ട റോഡ് ഷോ എക്സിബിഷൻ അത് തുടർന്നുള്ള കോവിഡ് മഹാമാരിയുടെ പശ്ചാത്തലത്തിൽ മാറ്റിവെച്ചിരിക്കുകയാണ്. തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും അത് തുടർന്നുള്ള മാസങ്ങളിൽ നമുക്ക് പ്രതീക്ഷിക്കാവുന്നതാണ്. ഈ അവസരത്തില് നന്ദി പ്രകാശിപ്പിക്കുകയാണ് എന്റെ കർത്തവ്യം. ലോക പരിസ്ഥിതി ദിനമായിരുന്ന ഈ ഗോ ഇലക്ട്രിക് ക്യാമ്പയിന്റെ പ്രാധാന്യം കണക്കിലെടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് നമുക്ക് ഒരു വളരെ ഒരു നല്ല സന്ദേശം നൽകിയ കേരളത്തിന്റെ എല്ലാ വികസന പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾക്കും ചുക്കാൻ പിടിക്കുന്ന കേരളത്തിന്റെ മുഖ്യമന്ത്രി ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട ശ്രീ പിണറായി വിജയൻ അവർക്ക് ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ എനർജി മാനേജ്മെന്റ് സെന്ററിന്റെ പേരിലുള്ള നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ കേരളത്തിന്റെ വൈദ്യുതി വകുപ്പ് മന്ത്രി ശ്രീ കൃഷ്ണൻകുട്ടി അവർകൾ, അദ്ദേഹമാണ് ഇ എം സിയുടെ ഗവർണിംഗ് ബോഡിയുടെ ചെയർമാൻ. ഇ എം സിയുടെ എല്ലാ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾക്കും എല്ലാ സപ്പോർട്ടും നൽകുന്ന ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട കൃഷ്ണൻകുട്ടി അവർക്ക് ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ ഈ എനർജി മാനേജ്മെന്റിന്റെ പേരുള്ള നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. ഗതാഗത മേഖലയിൽ പുത്തൻ ഉണർവ് നൽകുന്നതിനും നവീന ആശയങ്ങൾ പ്രചരിപ്പിക്കുന്നതിനും നേതൃത്വം നൽകുന്ന കേരളത്തിന്റെ ഗതാഗത വകുപ്പ് മന്ത്രി ശ്രീ ആന്റണി രാജു അവർക്ക് ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ എനർജി മാനേജ്മെന്റിന്റെ പേരുള്ള നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. അതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ ഈ നമ്മുടെ ഈ വെബിനാർ സീരീസിന് നമുക്ക് എന്റെ വെൽക്കം സ്വാഗതാശംസിക്കുകയും അതോടൊപ്പം എന്റെ പണി റിമാർക്സ് നൽകുകയും ചെയ്യുന്ന ഹരികുമാർ സാറിന് ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. വി ആൾസോ എക്സ്റ്റെൻഡ് മൈ വാം താങ്ക്സ് ടു ദ അവർ ടുഡേസ് ദ ടെക്നിക്കൽ പ്രസന്റേഷൻ ഡൺ ബൈ ടാറ്റാ മോട്ടോഴ്സ്. ശ്രീ ഋഷി തണ്ടൻ ഈസ് എ ജനറൽ മാനേജർ ഓഫ് ടാറ്റ മോട്ടോഴ്സ്. Along with Mr. Sandeep, Mr. Nitin Dilip, Mr. Sandeep Ranjan, we extended our sincere thanks to everybody from this Tata team. Also, the so many participants from outside and inside Kerala, we extended our sincere thanks to everybody. Adhubolu anne, ee nammude idile ഇൻട്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്ത എം സിയുടെ ജോയിന്റ് ഡയറക്ടർ ശ്രീ ദിനേശ് കുമാർ സാർ അവർകൾ, അദ്ദേഹത്തിനും ഈ അവസരം നന്ദി രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നു. അതേപോലെ തന്നെ ഈ പ്രോഗ്രാം കോർഡിനേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത ശ്രീ അനീഷ് രാജേന്ദ്രൻ, ശ്രീ ശരത് കൃഷ്ണൻ, ശ്രീ ഇജാസ്, അതുപോലെ തന്നെ അനൂപ് സുരേന്ദ്രൻ, ശ്രീ രാജീവ്, എല്ലാവർക്കും എനർജി മാനേജ്മെന്റിനുള്ള ഈ പ്രോഗ്രാം നമ്മൾ തുടരുന്നതായിരിക്കും. തുടർന്ന് കോവിഡ് ഓൺലൈനായിട്ട് വെബിനാർ മോഡിൽ തന്നെയായിരിക്കും. ഇതേപോലെ തന്നെ സൂം മീറ്റിംഗും എം സിയുടെ സോഷ്യൽ മീഡിയ ഫേസ്ബുക്ക് വഴി ലൈവ് ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കുന്നതാണ്. തുടർന്ന് നമ്മുടെ കോവിഡിന്റെ ഈ റെസ്ട്രിക്ഷൻ മാറിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഉടനെ നമുക്ക് ഇതിന്റെ റോഡ് ഷോയും അതുപോലെ തന്നെ എല്ലാ ജില്ലകളിലും ഓരോ എക്സിബിഷനും ഇലക്ട്രിക് മോട്ടോഴ്സിന് ജനങ്ങൾക്ക് പരിചയപ്പെടുത്തുന്നതിനും അതോടെ തന്നെ ഇലക്ട്രിക് കുക്കിംഗ് ഇപ്പം തന്നെ ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നതാണ്. അത് നമ്മുടെ കേരള ഗവൺമെന്റ് സ്മാർട്ട് കിച്ചൺ പദ്ധതിയുടെ ഭാഗമായിട്ട് അതും നമുക്ക് ഒരു ജനങ്ങളിലേക്ക് കൂടുതൽ എത്തിക്കുന്നതിന് നമ്മൾ ഈ പ്രോഗ്രാം വഴി സാധിക്കുമെന്ന് പ്രതീക്ഷിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ എന്റെ വാക്കുകൾ ഉപസംഹരിക്കുന്നു. നന്ദി, നമസ്കാരം.
താങ്ക് യു ജോൺസൺ സർ. സോ നൗ വി ഹാവ് സം ടൈം ഫോർ ടേക്കിംഗ് സം ക്യു ആൻഡ് എ. സോ വി വിൽ അഡ്രസ് some of the questions in the chat box. Mr. Josh George has had asked about about maintaining the battery. Is it require some kind of preventive maintenance? So I think Sharad Ranjan sir have given the reply. So I think that would be fine. You can, in the chat box it is mentioned, it is like we can use slow charging. Slow charging will be more healthy than fast charging, and fast charging can be used for every highway being used. It's recommended that fourth charging. So that I think the answer is clear. Okay, someone has asked, I think Mohan from can we get locations of charging station outlet? Okay, sorry, from Tata Motors team, you have any comment on that?
Thanks, Anichi. I will request my colleague Fayaz. Can you unmute Fayaz? Although he has mentioned the particular link where they can go and see the charging stations available nearby, even in the Kerala state also, our colleague, he has mentioned one link over there. It can be downloaded. Fayaz, can you take on this?
Sure, sir. So basically, all the chargers that are put up by Tata Group will be available on Tata Power EV Charge app as a single point. So currently, more than 450 chargers which are deployed across India can be accessed to Tata Power EV Charge app. Apart from this, for customers who are willing to access ASEB and other government body chargers, Electrify is a single point application wherein you can access all the remaining chargers. So for if you download these two applications, 90% of the chargers on field can be covered for your usage.
Yeah, thank you, sir. I think our governments are also working on centralized app or centralized application which can locate all the charging stations. Once the charging infrastructure is fully set up, I think that will be available for the public. Then on question from Ramanunni, so regarding the Nexon Ciptron technology, even though the Ciptron onboard 3.3 kilowatt converter gives a good charging rate, can we see any updates to 7 kilowatt onboard chargers on vehicles that are coming up in next phase?
So thanks, Anish, and I will request Sharad to unmute. Sharad, can you please take on this question? Sharad Ranjan.
Am I audible?
Yeah, Sharad Ranjan. Yeah,
I'm sorry. I was just trying to answer the questions on the comments. So could you just please repeat the question?
Sure, sir. I will repeat. Even though the Ciptron's onboard 3.3 kilowatt converter gives a good charging rate, can we see any updates to 7 kilowatt onboard chargers on the vehicles that are coming up in the next phase?
Yeah, so yes, the plan is there to, you know, put in 7 kilowatt chargers in our future cars. That is there. So product line is already there. With the present cars, you know, it is not being updated right now, but you can use those chargers, but the charging rate will still be limited to 3 kilowatt. Does that answer the question?
Okay, thank you, sir. And there is one more question from Mr. Bose Jacob. Is Tata into battery swapping for your vehicles? Is there any standard for battery swapping other than manufacturer specific?
No, sir. So presently, because battery, you know, in the battery space, we are not swapping the batteries at all. So because battery has a warranty and all, presently, no, we are not in the swapping space.
Okay, thank you, sir. I hope in the three-wheeler sector and two-wheeler sector, this will come.
Yes, so if you look across the world also, all major manufacturers, you know, you can take all major manufacturers from Tesla, Chevrolet, you know, none of them do it. There's a Chinese company that does it on a large scale, but other than that, not even European and US does it. But yeah, in the two-wheeler and three-wheeler sector, it is easier because of modularity and smaller battery size.
Yes. I think some cities in India, they have already started swapping, right?
Yes. They are. I mean, IOCL has also started a facility where they swap batteries for three wheelers.
Okay. So, thank you. Any other questions? Yeah. Okay. So many people have appreciated the initiative of EMC and the session from Tata. Thank you for that. Let me see any other questions are. Yeah, question from Mr. Guru Prasad. What will be the rate of rise in electricity bill from KSEB? I think it's a basic question. Yes, sir, you have any comments on that?
It depends. Nitin, you would like to take up, or Sandeep, you would like to take up? It depends on the electricity per unit consumption by the
If you got any feedback from customers, you can share that.
So, sir, Sharad out here. I mean, if you look at it, you know, different governments, state governments across different states are putting up, you know, special incentive for EV charging. So Delhi can be used as a benchmark where, you know, if you put a special meter, this is for home charging. They provide a charge of around 5 to 2 rupees to on a low tension. And I think high tension, they provide 5 rupees 50 paise per kWh. So Delhi is a benchmark right now, and I think if that gets replicated, adoption will go up.
Okay. In Kerala, currently, what will happen is if you charge from home, that will continue in your home connection. Whatever tariff you are following in your domestic tariff, that will be taken. And if you are charging from a dedicated charging station outside, there will be another tariff available based on the service provider. So that will be the case in Kerala. So some policy initiatives again has to work out. Now one question from Sir Renny. Price comparison of petrol Nexon to EV Nexon is almost doubled. So how feasible is going for an electric car at this high price? Okay, sir, I think you can take that question.
Rishi, you want me to take that question?
Yeah, I think Sandeep, you can take up this question.
Yeah, so let me just brief you with regards to the pricing. First of all, it's not double. When I look at the spec-to-spec comparison of the Nexon EV on-road in Kerala, as well as the Nexon diesel in Kerala, the price difference is about 3.5 lakh rupees. Okay. The reason for that is the life tax in Kerala is just about 5% for electric vehicles vis-a-vis 12 to 15% on a ICE vehicle. So hence the difference is not double, but 3.5 lakhs. When you take on road, ex-showroom wise, it may be different, but when you put the road taxes, etc., the difference is only 3.5 lakh. And second part is when you look at the cost of driving a vehicle. Now the Nexon EV, if you do home charging, will anywhere cost you between 60 paisa to let's say 80 paisa per kilometer is your cost of operating or per kilometer driving in a Nexon EV. When you go to a look at a petrol automatic vehicle, the Nexon, or any other car that you pick, it's close to about 7 to 8 rupees per kilometer. Because the petrol prices have almost touched 95 to 100 rupees a liter in the last few days as well. So when you take 7 to 8 rupees vis-a-vis 80 paisa in a electric car, the difference is 7 rupees per kilometer. So let us say if somebody is driving minimum, the average range driving is about 1,000 kilometers per day. That means 7,000 rupees is what you save per month. Now 7,000 rupees into, let's say if I put out maybe about, even if I take conservatively, maybe 3 years that a person drives this car, you save close to about 3 to 3.5 lakh rupees. So whatever upfront cost you're paying, you recover that within 3 years. And if your driving is more, within 1 year, 1.5 year, you'll recover that cost. And the best part is we are giving you a warranty for that covers 8 years and 1.6 lakh kilometers on the motor and on the battery. So that's the major component of the car itself. And easily you're going to drive this car much more than those many years. So for a lifetime savings is what you get. And this is at the cost of 100 rupees per liter today. Tomorrow, when this cost of petrol goes up to, let's say, 150 rupees or 125 rupees also, the replacement cycle or your recovery cost will be much faster. That is how an electric car or an electric vehicle is much better when you compare to an ICE car. I hope that answers the question.
Yeah, okay, sir. Thank you for that answer. Now, okay, Sunil Kumar, it is not relevant to this topic, but again, I'm asking how electric cooking of induction cooktop and electric rice cooker usage from promotion planning. It's a question is not clear. I think you can repeat the question. And yeah, I think some sessions will from electric cooking, harvesting more renewable energy is planned as part of this session in the next month and all. Some manufacturers are having some sessions. You can attend that. Now, yeah. Okay, Sharat Ranjan, okay, he has given the, okay, that answer. And yeah, ANSI, he asked, is any license required to put up electric charging station privately? Any support from government or vehicle manufacturers? What are the prerequisites to start a charging station? I hope, yes, ma'am, license and the energization sanction is required from the concerned electrical inspectorate department, who is taking care of the safety. And once the safety is ensured, you will be allotted with the particular tariff and connection from service connection from the Kerala State Electricity Board or whoever is the utility, they will provide you the service connection. And yeah, the government will of course support for such initiatives. Yeah, some Josh George has asked some give some comparison table with the economic benefit of EV with petrol vehicle. Any study done after taking into account the reduction of greenhouse gas? Okay, you have any contributions, sir, from Tata Motors?
So, sir, what we can do is they can connect with our local dealership. By the way, they can experience the vehicle also. There, they can give a detailed economics and give a say test ride of the vehicle and explain in each and every detail. I hope that will give them. Or Nitin, you would like to give anything? Or they can connect with my colleague Nitin or Sandeep for more details.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are asking the questions regarding to economics. Once I procure the electric vehicle, will it be economical? I think once in your outlets, you can give along with the test ride, people coming for test ride, you can give them a knowledge how it will be economic. And based on the current tariff in Kerala, you can have a study or some ready table or something. You can educate
sure,
the
consumers. So that sure, we have a dedicated sales team placed at the dealership looking after electric vehicles. They can visit the particular outlet and take experience and get experience on this particular vehicle, because unless and until you drive an electric car, you will not be experiencing that. I can give you that.
Yes, it is a very different experience. And Mr. Nikhil has asked, how about recycling or disposal procedure of expired batteries?
On this, certain things are working out. So right now, I can't comment on this, but certain things are being worked on in the process.
Okay, someone has asked, yeah, George, Tata has any plan to have dual motors in EVs? I think he's asking about hub motors or something.
So, Sharad, you would like to take it up? See, product is a constant process. So Sharad, you would like to take it up?
So, presently, you know, there's a single motor, you know. If the product develops and the requirement is filled, so I think the product line team will work on it. But presently, the product in present pipeline and the present products in the market are all single motors.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay, someone asked, this is a question from Mr. Vijay. in media, especially in social media, we see that in the electric car is really green. So generating of electricity, production of high energy material, solar panel production, generate electricity. How to convince the public? I think this question is with regards to the pollution from switching from conventional IC engine vehicles to electric vehicles. So there is a lot of debates going on this topic. Some people say that this electricity is generated at one end and carbon is emitted there. Still, you use electricity here. So like that, lot of debates are going on. So what is your view, sir, Tata Motors?
Rishi, shall I take that question?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so see, in terms of the generation of electricity, the power use, if you take India today, we are a power surplus country, right? And most of our power generation is through thermal resources. But if you take the recent last 6 months, government's policy has always been on renewable sources of energy. So once we have this power surplus taken care of, because today the coal cost is low, hence our nation's dependence on thermal power generation is high. But as and when we move towards the electric campaign and we have enough users of electric car, right now we're just about less than 1% of our dependence is on electric automobiles. You take it two wheelers, three wheelers or four wheelers. Once this reaches to, let us say, 30-40%, renewable sources of energy will take place. Even if you take most of the airports, they are setting up solar panels. If you take one of the so many sources of energy are going towards renewable. So gradually you'll see that shift going from thermal to renewable. And that is where this, like Rishi mentioned about the chicken and egg story of charging and station setup. Today also we are in the same phase. Once the generation is high enough, India will automatically move towards renewable. And in India today, we have surplus sunlight, we have surplus wind resources, which will be enough and more to take care of this electricity generation. So we are in the start of this process. If we leave it right now, we'll always be dependent on thermal. But if we take this further, it will move towards renewable sources of energy. I hope that answers the question.
Yes, exactly what you have said, Sandeep. Thank you. And adding to that, one more thing is that this IC engine, it's basically the efficiency is very poor compared to the electric motors. So the per unit carbon emission per unit fuel will be more in case of fossil fuels like petrol and diesel. And so as you rightly said, the increased penetration of renewable energy, as the government is very much targeting on this this new government has come set up. So Kerala government also very much focused on policies like Saura and solar rooftops for every households, and the government offices also they are planning. So the increase in that shift in energy mix will properly reduce the carbon footprints, and that will be a upper hand and switching to green. So that's why we put on this topic and on a World Environment Day, since it is a green initiative. So any other questions? Let me see. I think a lot of appreciations and thanks to Tata Motors team. A lot of people have appreciated the session. So some people have asked regarding the fire hazards. So the testing, if any fire happens during an accident or something, you can give a picture on that. So I think multiple questions are there regarding the same. So if some accident happens, so if the battery explodes or something, the fire possibility is high compared to the other IC engine vehicle. So what is your view on that?
Sharad, can you take it up this? And Anish sir, he has also given certain facts in the test book, but nonetheless, Sharad, can you please take up?
So I had already answered this. So see, the present standard for testing electric vehicle is in India for all hazards is AIS 052. So our vehicle has already been certified for this. So yeah, this is a common conception, you know, that in terms of petrol and diesel, this is, you know, there's a higher fire hazard. But if you look across the data, it is not so. I mean, and we have passed the most stringent safety test out here. So there is, you know, there's an HVAL circuit. And if there's any breach in insulation, the supply is completely cut off. So the chances are very minimal.
Okay, and also for that battery, you are giving some special casing, right? For if some
it is IP67 certification is there, which means it will be there's no breach of dust and moisture, which you know keeps the battery
also
healthy.
In the case of collisions, also it is, I think, some strong casing is given, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so we can take this last question, and any further questions, I think you can add your email ID to the chat box so that the participants can send the questions to that. So I think this is the last question. Is there any plan for Tata EVs to launch outside India?
So the point here is we will be taking it up to the other nations as our business plan will confirm, and you may hear in the near future also, but right now we are concentrating more in India. We will cater the demand in India and we will move outside, but that's a plan from the company side. So company will respond, and we have a designated department who looks after the exports. They will look into it. We are from the domestic one. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. So that's all from the Q&A session, and I once again thank the speakers and the team from Tata Motors, especially Sandeep sir and Nitin Philip, who have been coordinating this event from a long time. We have been coordinating with them, and they were very helpful in sharing this session and all the details to Energy Management Center to make this program happen. And so this being a World Environment Day, we have released this talk, and and the continuing with this program, we have a series of webinars, as our director sir has mentioned. The next week, this coming Wednesday, it will not be there. I think on this I mentioned the date. I think on 16th of June, there will be another session on electric vehicle charging infrastructure and its economics. It will be handled by Delta Electronics. So that will be our next session. And some sessions will be then after that, there will be for every Wednesday, one session will be there for some sessions on our two-wheeler, and some sessions are on electric cooking, and some sessions on electric cars also. So different manufacturers will share their experience, and you can also interact with them. So that's all from my side, and wish you all a very good day. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Nanish, and thanks to everyone for giving us opportunity and supporting us. Let's move and say goodbye to fuel and hello electric. Over to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.